Hello, this is Justin back with an engineer's perspective. And I finally picked up some S45VN. I saw Erica from Not Your Average EDC's. Is that her channel name still? I'm sorry, Erica. I forget. Anyways, I saw her video on her all black S45VN Para 3. And I was just like, man, you know what? I'm going to do it. And yeah, I mean, just I wanted to try it out. It's a mid-range stainless steel, a mid-range PM stainless steel. So it's kind of in the middle of the PM range, not in the overall scheme of things, high-end. But anyways, I digress. After watching that, I decided I just really wanted to give it a crack and get back into the world of these stainless PM steels. I was also extremely butthurt about not scoring one of the 15V Manix 2s that Spyderco and Triple B did. So, yeah, this is kind of me licking my wounds and trying to make myself feel good again. However, after seeing SHOT Show, they are coming out with a PM2 and a Shaman in 15V, so I'll be looking for that PM2. The Shaman is just too thick a geometry for me to enjoy, so I'll be looking for that one, trying to score that. But yeah, S45VN. I'm going to do one of my paper steel comparison videos on S45VN, but long story short, on S45VN is what kind of... do the iterations here. So quite some time ago, Spyderco and Chris Reeves and Crucible and maybe others came up with S30V as a purpose-built all-around stainless steel for knives. Then as an improvement on it, or in their minds, a small iterative improvement was S35VN. And so the concept with S30V is that it would be plenty stainless, be tough enough, and have a nice carbide amount. And they went way about doing that by not going crazy with the carbon amount and a 4% vanadium, so that most of it can get used, or a handful of it can get used in vanadium carbides and chromium-enriched vanadium-enriched chromium carbides. What you get is something that's kind of, it's good enough all around, but nothing too special and not quite tough enough to be run at high levels of hardness, with a level of carbon that are in it for a lot of mass manufacturers. Then they iterated up to S35VN, the V being vanadium, the N standing for niobium now. Reduce that vanadium, I believe, is down from 4% in S30V down to 3.5%, and a little bit of niobium. Adjusted the chromium up, I believe, and then I think they might have played around with the carbon a little bit. Thought process there, more stainless, less carbide to make it tougher. And so with the addition of the niobium too, is basically it kind of shifts your balance where you can have more of the hard phase kind of MC type carbide being niobium carbides and vanadium carbides without the niobium wanting to combine with chromium like vanadium does want to. So you get more of those MC type carbides for that level of carbon and chromium. But what you ended up getting was a steel that generally was run a little bit too soft overall, sub 60 generally. And not enough carbide to really have anything that's too fun. So not most people's favorite steel. Tends to sharpen, like the edge it takes is very fine. So if that's what you're looking for, that's a pretty fun way to go with it. But I always preferred the edge I'd get off of S30V. And I feel like S30V, I can do a wider variety of edges and get the performance I want. Whereas S35VN, for me, I really prefer a polished edge on it, talking like Spyderco Ultra Fine. And then iterating from S35VN up to S45VN, I don't remember the levels of vanadium and niobium. I will do the full comparison, but basically, they went for more carbide and more carbon, I believe. And it's still very stainless, which is kind of silly that I got the coated version, but that's what was in my local store. And they didn't have a box, so they gave me 20% off. That was worth it. And the fit and finish is where I want it to be. So S45VN, basically, it is tough enough where companies are willing to run it hard and they can get it hard without too much of a fuss. And so, what we had is a steel is maxing out at like 61 production, but usually more like 58 to 60 in S35VN. Companies didn't really push the limits anymore with it. Whereas this S45VN, it seems like nobody is going under 60 in the production realm, like 60 to 62, which is really nice. Are finally getting in that area just right off the hop on S45VN. And then the nice thing about it is it seems to still have really high levels of toughness, more in S35VN range, but have the carbide of S30V. I don't know the makeup between chromium and vanadium and niobium, but much more favorable than S35VN. And so basically, it combines the distinct advantages of S30V and S35VN and then bumps them up a little bit. And this is just a small iteration, just really carefully playing with not putting too much carbon and chromium in the steel so you don't push chromium out of solution and end up forming lots of chromium carbides. And so it's a really fun kind of dance that they do with these and that they've progressed to. And it just really sounds like S45VN is a winner in the hardness category, in the toughness category, edge stability, and carbides. So yeah, I just really wanted to give it a shot, especially after Erica's glowing review. And so yeah, I kind of went through my normal, is this flush for a paramilitary style knife? Centering's good. Action's good. Open and close. No side to side. No up and down. Last thing, no lock stick. And then the last thing I like to check is you can actually go like this, and I'm going to pull back and forth. You're not able to see anything, but there is a little bit of movement, meaning that the pivot isn't exactly the same size as the hole. I generally look for no movement in my knives, but it's very minimal and it's so good everywhere else that I give it a pass. So those are things I like to look for in my production knives, just to kind of say, yep, that's the one I want, or just, hey, can you grab me another box of one and I'll look at that one instead. So yeah, really excited to try this out. I've got the stainless steels I really prefer up here. I'm not sure why I like LC200N so much, but I do. M390, love this M390 Para 3. It's fantastic. I really want to see if it can start trading punches with something like that. I mean, if we're getting this type of performance out of this steel, which we'll see, it really depends on how this is heat treated, if it's going to approach this level of carbide or not. But this is going to be a real winner if it starts tickling that. And then S90V is just really fantastic. I really enjoy that. So yeah, that's kind of that. So yeah, this is just me kind of letting you guys know. Join the S45 VN party. I am definitely going to be getting the 15V PM2. If I can, I'm gonna try. I tried hard for the Mannix and I just wasn't able to score. So yeah. But yeah, for now, I'm gonna be rocking this S45VN. And I think once I get a little tired of it, then I'll flip back to either S35 or S30V and just kind of get some comparisons in there and we will talk about it. So that's all I've got for today. Have a good one. Bye.